I'd rather have a science balloon than a science satellite. With a balloon, there's no need for rockets. To get a satellite to hover over the same spot on Earth, geostationary orbit, you have to be 36,000 kilometers away, too far to use some sensors, like radar. A balloon can sit 1,000 times closer, in the stratosphere, 30 to 40 kilometers above the Earth, and still be above 99% of the atmosphere with clear views of the stars or wide panoramas of Earth. You can bring down a balloon, tinker with onboard scientific equipment, and then launch again. Satellites, not so much. Cost is also a factor. NOAA's four new geostationary weather satellites are estimated to cost $11 billion, whereas a balloon flight might cost just a few hundred thousand dollars. NASA's been flying balloons for a long time, but without any steering capabilities, they drift in the wind across continents. Now, private industry is getting in the balloon game, with new technologies that are enabling balloons to hover over one spot. These balloons rise and fall in the stratosphere, catching countervailing breezes that allow them to stay roughly in the same place. What can a balloon with a scientific payload do? It can look down at the Earth, checking on storms or animal migrations. It can look out into space, peering at the surface of the sun or collecting cosmic rays. It can even do things in the stratosphere, like studying how ice crystals could reflect sunlight and cool the planet. How do you keep a balloon stable enough to use a telescope? Gyroscopes can help keep a platform pointed at its target, even as it sits in a twisting gondola. But this isn't an ad for scientific balloons. There are a few caveats. For example, while satellites last for years, the longest balloon flights have been a few months. And what goes up needs to come down, so most balloons come with parachutes that can bring their payloads down gently.